Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of...
They know about the stonewalling you've had from the Council.
They deserve to know what we're up against.
They're on your side. They're pissed about the resistance we're getting, especially from our side. I'll have a better handle on all of it when my head stops hurting. Another L2 flare-up.
Anything I can do?
No, Commander, it'll settle down. It's rough sometimes, but they spike higher than a lot of L3s. Except for you, of course. Besides, I fared a lot better than some after Kinetics was through.
I haven't heard anything about Kinetics in a while.
Yeah, they quietly disappeared. Broke up into a bunch of little corps after they botched the training on Jump Zero. After first contact, Kinetics was set up to track Element Zero exposures and develop implants for humans. Once we had an embassy on the Citadel, Kinetics could bring in experts instead of taking it slow.
I'm sure Kinetics did what they thought was best.
It wasn't best for us. They brought in an ex-military Turian named Commander Vernus. A real hard ass. He basically had a free pass to break us if it would turn out a decent biotic. Kind of spiraled from there, Commander.
Did he ever face charges for that?
He got his, yeah. But like everything else at Jump Zero, it was under the table. The less said, the better. This is ancient stuff. I walked it off a long time ago. I should get back to my duties, Commander. We're here to make history, not rehash it.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I like talking with you, Liara, no matter what the subject.
You have been very understanding with me, Shepard. Very patient. I appreciate that. I know there are some strange beliefs about my people. I am familiar with the legend of Asari promiscuity, but those rumors have little basis in fact. When one of my people joins with an individual from another species, it is a very deep and spiritual exchange. We do not enter lightly into a union.
You make it sound almost mystical.
A true union goes far beyond an ordinary melding. It is a connection that transcends the physical universe. Two become one. Thoughts and senses merge, identities intertwine. Memories and emotions weave themselves together, becoming entangled in a single, rapturous whole. It is unlike any other experience. In some cases, it can be a truly life-changing event.
Sounds amazing. Are you saying...
No. Oh, no. I am not very good at this, am I? I'm sorry, Shepard. I am trying to explain why I have been so... reserved. The Union is more than just sex. It is the lifeblood of my species, the way we Asari evolve and grow as a society. That is why I have never... That is why we must choose our partners with great care.
I want you to be absolutely sure about this, Liara.
I am only 106, barely an adult by Asari standards, and I spend most of my time absorbed in my research. I never really thought about it. Not until I met you. You are very special to me, Shepard. But with all that's happened, Saren, the Geth, the Reapers, I do not know if we are ready for this.
These are dark times, Liara. Maybe once all this is over.
I'm glad you understand, Shepard. There is too much at stake. We need to put aside our personal feelings and focus on stopping Saren. I wish it did not have to be that way. But we all have to make sacrifices. Let's talk about something else.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Playing the long game.
Shepard?
So, you'd rather be a merc than help you?
I'm a fighter. It's what I do. What the hell do you want me to do about it? I'm tired of sticking my ass on the line and getting nothing for it.
So you decided to go your own way?
I decided killing for credits was better than... I'm no hero. Bottom line, killing for credits simplifies things.
You ever think about helping your people?
But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Thank you. Commander?
Do you have a few minutes to talk one-on-one?
I'm off duty until tomorrow. I was gonna have a small drink, bit of a celebration, if you're interested.
With all we've been through lately? Hell yes.
I only have enough to toast the day, not the captain. It's Armistice Day, when the First Contact War ended. My family always marks it. Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
Seems like an odd thing to celebrate. That was 26 years ago.
In our family, it's not really a celebration, more like an obligation. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shanxi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
I see. That's why you drive yourself so hard.
A Williams has to be better than the best, if only to avoid suspicion. That's what my dad told me the night before he retired. It takes a special kind of thick-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
Is this why you're always going on about the Council?
If everyone else can look at Shanxi and say, this is why humanity needs to be stronger, then so can I. I'm entitled. So now you know. Gonna kick me off the ship, Skipper?
You're part of the team, Williams. I don't care what your grandfather did or didn't do.
Not to get all cheesy, but you're the first CO who's ever said that to me. Thanks, Skipper. But anyway, I've got things to do before we land. I'm sure you do too.
Dismissed, Chief.
Sir.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but if there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
Thank you, Garrus. I'll keep that in mind. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do catch him.
Yes, sir. I'll be ready. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
You seem to have some thoughts on this. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
It'll depend on the situation. I'm not committing to anything until I've got him in my sights.
Fair enough. Either way, I'm right behind you, Commander.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Thank you.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Thank you.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've
got.
You
bet, Commander. Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander. Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
It feels like we're getting near the end, doesn't it, Shepard? With Saren, I mean.
It won't be much longer. One way or another, it'll all be over soon.
You'll find the conduit before he does. I know you will. You have to. And after this is all over, when my pilgrimage ends and I go back to my own people, I'll be proud to say I was a part of it.
We couldn't have done this without you, Telly.
You've been good to me. A lot of people treat Quarians like second-class citizens. They just want us to go back to our fleet and disappear. But you've treated me just like everyone else on your crew. Like an equal. That means a lot, and it says something about you. Whatever happens, I just want to say thank you for that.
I'm gonna miss you when you go back to your own people, Telly.
That won't happen for a while yet. I'll be right here anytime you need me.
I should go.
See you later.
Giving you guys the full playthrough with all the dirty deets and all the minutia that you don't need to see, but I'm gonna show you anyway, because that's the authentic playing experience. Just like me not talking for 40 minutes and then deciding to give you guys a commentary on the nothing that I'm doing. I should probably look and see what I'm supposed to be doing here.
Thank you.
Commander, I'm reading a signal. Must be our Solarian infiltration team.
Check out those defense towers.
Drop the Mako. We'll go in hot and take them out.
I'll get you in underneath their radar, Commander. Got a clean drop, Commander.
Stay out of range and continue evasive maneuvers until I bring those AA towers down.
I know the drill. Meet you at the camp once those towers are offline. Joke around.
A rock lobster. Thank you. harpoon. That's exciting. Well, I got the Himawasser. I don't even know what you do with Omnigel, but I'm making more of it. You know what that means? Music stops, so do I. You know, there'll be more. It is what it is.